Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. Today we are going to take a short tricks to find out the square root of a complex number. This question is very important for your examination point of view as well as for your competitive exam. If you are preparing yourself for NDA or JEE mains for IIT admissions, then this tricks may be help in your final as well as in your competitive exams. So what's the short trick and what's the logic behind the it? We have discussed one by one. In this lecture, we have to take short tricks to find out the square root of any complex number within 10 seconds. It's very easy. Firstly, you have to keep some points. If you learn them and do practice, then you can solve such type of question within 10 seconds or even fast. What's the trick and what's the point? You have to keep it in your minds. So we have to solve it within 10 seconds. It comes as in NDA as well as JEE mains for taking admission for IITs. First step is we have to put x square minus y square is equal to real part. Do you know what's the real part is in any complex number? For example, if I am going to take this complex number and we have to find the square root of this complex number, then what's the real part is here? 7. So we have to put x square minus y square is equal to real part, which is equal to 7 in this case. Second step, put 2xy is equal to imaginary part. What's the imaginary part in this case? 24. Now what's the third step? Third step is x square plus y square we have to find, and which is what? Basically square of real part plus square of imaginary part. It means square of 7 plus square of 24, and we have to take square root. We will find x square plus y square. Now what's the fourth step is to solve. 2x square is what? Equation number 1 plus equation number of 3. It means we have to add 1 and 3. Step 5. Find the values of y using equation 2. What is equation 2? 2xy is equal to imaginary part. We have to use this equation. Now step 6. We have to put all the values of x and y in the equation z is equal to x plus iota y, and this is your final answer. So starting, you have to learn these steps. I think these steps are lengthy, but whenever you try to do solve, then such steps you learn very quickly and do questions very fast. How the trick and how we can apply all these steps, please make a look here. I'm doing solve. First step is what? Put x square plus minus y square is equal to real part. It means x square minus y square is equal to real part is here 7. Second step is 2xy is equal to imaginary part. We have to put 2xy is equal to imaginary part. What's the imaginary part is plus 24. So I write this. Now third step is what? We have to calculate x square plus y square, which is square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. So third step is x square plus y square is equal to square root of real parts 7 square, square root of imaginary part 24 square. If we solve it, what's the result? 7 square is 49 and 24 is 576. We got 625, and what's the square root of 625 is 25. So we get x square plus y square is equal to 25. This one is equation 1, this is 2, this one is equation 3. Now what's the next step is? Solve 2x square is equal to equation number 1 plus equation number of 3. So 2x square is equal to equation number of 1, 7, plus equation number of 3, 25, which is equal to 32, and we have to solve for x. So if we divide 2 in the denominator, what we will got? 32 divided by 2. 32 divided by 16. It means I am solving here. Now x square is equal to 16. It means x is equal to plus minus 4. We get x values. Now second step is, last step is, find the values of y using equation 2. This is the equation 2. 2xy is equal to 24. Now I am taking here we got two values of x. X one is positive 4 and second one is negative 4. If I am taking x is equal to positive 4, now put it here, positive 4 into y. 2 into 4, 8. 24 by 8 which is equal to 3. So we get y is equal to positive 3. Now same if I put it negative. So this sign becomes negative and if take this sign, we will got y is equal to negative 3. It means we got the values of x and y both. And what's the answer is? Answer is z is equal to x plus iota y. Now what's the values of x? X values is plus minus 4. So answer is plus minus 4. Now if we take x is positive 4, then y is again positive 3. It means we get positive 3. Now if we take x is negative 4, we get y is again negative. It means negative 3. And we have to take sign iota. So this is your final answer. So you can also write it as by taking plus minus as a common. Plus minus 4 plus 3 iota. This one is your final answer. Startingly, you will take some time, but whenever you try to do more practice, you can do such type of question on these tricks very quickly within 10 seconds. So please keep all these points and try to learn. Then we try to solve 2 or 3 questions more. Please make a look. Now we have to solve our second question. I am giving another example, 5 minus 12 iota, we have to find out the square root. Now you try to do fast. First step is put x square minus y square is equal to real part.
X square minus y square is equal to real part.
What's the second step is put 2xy is equal to imaginary part.
2xy is equal to imaginary part is here negative 2.
Third step is to find x square plus y square, which is square root of real part square plus imaginary part square.
X square plus y square is equal to 5 square plus minus 12 square. So we know 5 square is 25 and plus 144. We get 169. And what the square root of 169 is? 13. So we get x square plus y square is equal to 13. This one is your first equation, this is your second equation, and this is your third equation.
Now next step is we have to find 2x square. What is 2x square? Equation 1 plus equation 3. Now add it, 5 plus 13 which is equal to 18. So 2x square is equal to 18. Then x square is equal to 18 by 2 which is equal to 9. So x square is equal to 9. It means x is equal to plus minus 3. We get the values of x. Now we have to solve for y. What's the value? We have to use equation number 2. 2xy is equal to what? Minus 12. Take two values. First I am going to take x is equal to plus 3. X is equal to plus 3. Now solve this. 2 into 3 into y is equal to minus 12. 2 into 3, 6. If we divide by 6, we get minus 2. So y is minus 2. Now if we take x is equal to minus 3, naturally 2 into minus 3 y, it becomes minus 6, and if we divide, we get positive y is equal to 2. So in this case, what's the answer is? Our answer is always z is equal to x plus minus iota. What's the value of x is? Plus minus 3.
Plus minus 3.
Now when I take x is positive 3, what is the value of y? When I am taking x is equal to positive 3, the value of y is negative. That's why I take here negative 2. When I take x is equal to negative 3, it becomes positive. So here we have to write here plus 2. In this, the sign becomes changed. When I am taking x is equal to positive 3, we get negative 2. When I am taking x is negative 3, we get positive 2. So if we take common plus minus, so the sign becomes here negative. This is our final answer. Please make a note. Too fast. Now I am going to take another example. We have to find out square root of minus 2 plus 2 root 3 iota. Now to start very quickly, our first step is x square minus y square is what? Real part. What's the real part is here? Minus 2. What's the second step is put 2xy is equal to imaginary part. What's the imaginary part is here? 2 root 3. Now third step is we have to find x square plus y square which is equal to square root of real parts. What's the real part is? Minus 2. What's the imaginary part is? 2 root 3. Now solve for what we will got? Minus 2 square is 4. And 2 square is 4 into 3 is 12. So we got 16 which is equal to 4. So we got x square plus y square is equal to 4. This one equation 1, this is equation 2, this equation 3. Now we have to solve. What we have to solve? 2x square is equal to equation 3 plus equation 1. Which is equation 1 is what? Minus 2. And third is what? 4. We got plus 2. It means 2x square is equal to 2, x square is equal to 1. It means x is equal to plus minus 1. Now we have to solve using equation 2. What's the equation 2 is? 2xy is equal to 2 root 3. We have two values, x is equal to 1 and minus 1. When our takes x is equal to plus 1, 2 into 1, y is equal to 2 root 3. What's the value is? Root 3. While I'm taking x is equal to negative 1, so 2 into minus 1, y is equal to 2 root 3. Y becomes negative root 3. So our answer is what? Our answer is z is equal to, what's the values of x is? Plus minus 1. When I take x is equal to 1, we get plus root 3. It means we get plus root 3. And when I take x is equal to negative, we get y is equal to again negative. And the last part we have to take iota. If we take common out, plus minus, we get 1 plus root 3 iota. This one is your final answer. I hope you understand this video, and if you like my video, do subscribe and do share it with your friends to crack ND as well as JEE Mains for your preparation. So I will take a next trick and we will meet very soon. Thank you for watching my video.